Testing, testing. Can you hear me? Testing, 1, 2. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Got it?
Test, test.
Thank you.
Test, test. Test, test.
Can we do this? Numbers go on.
Test, test. Test, test.
Welcome to tonight's basketball game between the Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders and St. Andrews University Cardinals. The National Christian College Athletic Association is committed to the true spirit of competition and upholding the four core values of the game plan for life: love, integrity, faith, and excellence. We ask that each participant, official, and spectator join us in exhibiting these Christ-like characteristics and help create a positive environment in which to enjoy today's competition. Please stand and join us as Carmichael, assistant coach, leads us in prayer.
Let's stand. Gentlemen, please remove your hats. Father God, thank you for this opportunity to play this game called basketball. But more so, thank you for the sacrifice of your son, Jesus, so we can have this wonderful opportunity to express our passion and our will through this game. Allow both teams to play without hurt, harm, or danger, and allow both teams to be exemplary in their exhibition of sportsmanship. We thank you. We give you all the praise and honor. In Jesus Christ we pray.
Please remain standing, gentlemen. Please remove your hats as Hillary leads us in a singing of our passion.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
For your visitors. For your visitors, for Andrews.
Are they good?
As we go to the starting lineup. Number two, Gabe Beckton. Number 15, Kobe Meyer. Number 24, Robert Moon. Number 32, Brandon Von Dorpowski. And number 44, Andrew Simpson. Andrews is coached by head coach Michael Paulus. Now put your hands together for your Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders. Okay. He's a freshman from Pontiac, Michigan. Number 10, Dana Thomas. He's a freshman from Detroit, Michigan. Number 22, Sean Gorton. He's a sophomore from Detroit, Michigan. Number 23, Vidal Jackson. He's a sophomore from Barnum, Minnesota. Number 42, Sam Anderson. He's a freshman from Barcelona, Spain. Number 44, Sean Rutledge. Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Doty Center, home of Great Lakes Christian College. Tonight, the Lakes taking on the visiting Cardinals from Andrews University in Berrien Springs, Michigan. Well, tonight for the Lakes, number 23, Vidal Jackson, getting his first start with the team. What do you think he brings to the table? I'm Colton Wesley. This is my partner, Jonathan Crutcher. Rev, what do you think he brings to the table?
You know, Vidal instantly brings to the table a solid offensive game that works hard, that loves the game, and everyone's excited to have him. And it's gonna be great to have him on the team to see what he brings and adds, because he's an important part of what this team wants to do.
Rutledge drives, kick out, Colton. This is Dana Thomas up in the air, that's knocked away. Coming the other way now, Robert Moon. Moon running the floor for Andrews, goes up, lays it
two
in.
2 points for number 24, Robert Moon.
Coming the other way, Sean Rutledge over the timeline. Tries to step into the key and we have a whistle.
Stop the clock, stop the clock.
So the Lakes going with a bit of a different lineup tonight. Dana Thomas and Sam Anderson getting the starts. They don't start all that often.
You wonder if, and that's a terrible inbound pass there, stolen by number 32.
Coming the other way now, Gabriel Becton passes underneath. Andrew Simpson gets above
two
the rim, knocks it down, and it's 4-0 Cardinals.
Andrew Simpson.
And Great Lakes right now just not taking care of the ball. And so Great Lakes has to do a better job of that. And so far, the passes have been flat, and they aren't making it. And so look for Great Lakes. Great Lakes has to rev it up a little, because right now, Andrew's just getting uncontested runouts and easy baskets. So
this is Colton in the high post, 12 to shoot. Down low, Anderson tries to feed it underneath to Thomas, and it's stolen, and we have a whistle. And a double dribble on Colby Meyer will keep the ball down here. So Great Lakes will inbound from the baseline, down 4-0 here in the early going, 18:29 to go.
And you have Tommy Bentley and David Parks checking into the game for the Lakes.
Inbound is stolen, coming the other way now is Brandon Vonderpolski. Goes rack to rack, lays it in, and one.
And so far, Great Lakes just not taking care of the ball. And it's not a smart foul right there by Vidal Jackson, as it's now 8-0. And
his
Great
first.
Lakes, Coach John cannot be pleased with how Great Lakes is playing.
And we have a timeout. John Piercefield wants a timeout already.
30 seconds.
18:24 to go here in the first. Lakes down 8-0. What can the Lakes do to stem this tide?
So Great Lakes just looking to do a better job of working the ball around and moving the ball and being – no, it's 1-1. And being a better team as the fouls right now, it's 1-1. We have a foul number 23, Vidal Jackson, and a foul number 2, Gabriel Becken from Andrews. So right now the foul's been 1-1, but so far Great Lakes has to do a better job of taking care of the ball and playing better defense. And, I mean, obviously you can't really play defense when you aren't getting back because you keep turning the ball over, so... if they stop turning the ball over, the defense hopefully will solve itself.
Brandon Vonderpolski on the line.
Interesting name.
Hits the first. Correction, he hits the three-point play. So it's 9-0 Cardinals. This is Rutledge. He's going
to
run the point.
Do a better job, as I said, of working the ball around.
Drives the key, puts it up. He knocks it down.
For number 44.
Rutledge, a 5'6" guard.
And Sean saw a hole in the defense there. He takes advantage of it and gets a really good shot. And that's important because Sean's really quick. We saw him get by people in the Kuiper game, but he wasn't able to get good shots. And there's a steal by Sean Colton.
Colton with the steal, gives it to Rutledge over the timeline now. Under 18 to go here in the first. This is Colton into the corner, David Parks. Andrews in a 2-3 zone. Jackson pulls up for three, knocks it down.
For number 23.
Welcome to Great Lakes, Vidal Jackson.
And Vidal Jackson is one of the best shooters the Great Lakes has had in a long time. He's a really fundamental player, a really good scorer, and it's great to have him. And so look forward to seeing that more often.
Colby Meyer inside, wide open look for Robert Moon, and he knocks it down.
24.
And Tommy Bentley got shoved up on someone's foot there. And it left a wide open basket, unfortunately.
This is Parks. 17
and
a quarter left
in
the first.
Doing a good job.
That one goes off the foot of Mike Oliveira.
Great Lakes is not doing a good job of not being stationary. The ball keeps freezing. No. The ball keeps freezing, and the ball needs to keep rotating. And David gets an open look, and it's no good. Rebounded by number 44, Andrew Simpson.
That was a good look for Parks right there. He's been up and down. He's been really inconsistent with the three-point shot. Hopefully he can pick it up this second semester. The Lakes are going to need it.
One of the things I will say about David, his percentages are probably about 10% higher on the road than it is at home, I would say.
Worth noting.
And that's something.
Colby Meyer goes up and under.
Oh, that's a block by David. And that's another block by David. Two blocks by David Parks.
Coming the other way now, Sean Colton. Parks pulls up. He's in the corner now. Goes all the way across to Jackson, drives the lane, up, and he's fouled.
And Vidal draws a foul there, and right there, Vidal sees the baseline. He's really aggressive, and he makes a great move. And so far, Great Lakes is playing better. But you have to admit, partner, that there's still too much standing around, and the ball's not swinging quick enough.
It's true. Lakes off to a bit of a slow start. Hopefully they'll pick it up here. It's 11-5.
And we both know, to beat great teams in our region, Grace, Kuiper, Maranatha, the ball can't just get stationary.
First free throw from Jackson is no good, and you're right, and that's really what Great Lakes have struggled with, to be honest. They haven't swung the ball around the perimeter, and they've got to get it inside to the big guy. Now that they have him in Vidal Jackson, Jimbo Harvey coming off the bench later on, they've got the size underneath they didn't have earlier in the season.
And this team has more scoring than it's had all year. You know, it's always been looking for a go-to scorer, and they're really hoping that Vidal brings that.
Two points, and that's just too easy right there.
No one cuts number 15 off. He goes coast to coast.
Colby Meyer on the basket. Now this is Sean Rutledge. Holds up. Gives it to Parks.
And once again, the ball just gets stuck in one place.
Jackson pulls long three. No good off the back rim. Not a bad look, really. Coming the other way now. No. It's stolen by Colton away from Vanderpolsky. Now he gives it to Parks. Inside stolen. Vanderpolsky able to get it back, and now he's got it coming the other way. Goes up. An old good off the front rim. Rebound. Sean Colton, he's coming the other way. Lakes playing at a fast pace here. Colton gives it to Rutledge. Wanted him in the corner. And it's a misplayed ball and goes out over the sideline.
I'm not sure who that turnover will be by. Six. Oh, yeah. We have six.
Gabriel Becton running the point for the Cardinals. Vanderpolsky loses the ball. Bentley got a hand on it. Now Cardinals will retain possession.
Really repping it up on defense. They're actually playing man today. So this is going to be interesting. This is what happens when you get a little bit more height, but you have to stay on your feet.
2 points for number 15.
Meyer went right around Sean Colton and deposited it in the bucket. 15-6. 15-16 on the clock. Colton in the corner. Kicks it all the way back out to Parks. Lakes will reset. Parks pulls for three. Knocks it down.
For number 30, David Parks.
And as we say, if you give David a lot of, oh, it's nine. If you give David a lot of open looks, David will knock a few of them down. He's going to take a lot of shots. He always takes a lot of shots.
15 minutes to go here in the first. Lakes down six. This is Moon. Becton holding it up in the high post into the corner. Now back out to Andrew Simpson. Simpson looking for an option, gives it to Becton. Plays it across to Meyer, who goes to the rack and knocks it down. Nice run from Colby Meyer. He's got six.
And
the 6'6 sophomore.
And Sean Colton right there is just watching the ball. He's not watching his man. And so his man goes right around him.
Inside, outside, Parks for three, no good. Good passing movement, but the Lakes unable to finish an open look. Coming the other way now, this is Moon. Takes it all the way in, and it's a charge going the other way. That'll be the first on Robert Moon.
And Sean taking a charge there.
His first, team third.
His team third. So three fouls on Andrews.
This is Rutledge.
And so, Great Lakes.
Sean Colton.
The ball just can't keep getting stuck.
This is Jackson
right
at the
Everyone
top.
Everyone has to move, cut, and rotate. And Tommy gets a tough shot. It's not a good shot.
Not the best of shot selection right there by Bentley. Maybe he needs to work that back around. The Lakes in a bit too much of a hurry, and we have a whistle. And a foul on Rutledge.
44 White. His first, team second.
Horn. No, it's still two.
17-9, 13:58 to go here in the first. Moon, Becton.
So,
picks up a screen, puts it underneath, back to Moon, layup no good. The tip is in from Simpson. 5'11 guard, came out of nowhere. I don't know. I don't think he's 5'11.
No, he's definitely taller than 5'11. That's definitely a misprint. But so far, it's a 10-point game. And once again, the ball's stationary. Great Lakes has to work the ball around.
Bentley. This is Quentin Howard, who just checked into the game. Howard moves past his man, goes up, gets it blocked by Simpson.
Who's not 5'9".
No, he's not 5'11", as the roster says he is.
Yeah, he's definitely taller than 5'11", because, I mean, he just stood there and blocked Q's shot. And Great Lakes actually able to inbound the ball there. I think we've had three turnovers from inbounding the ball.
Tries to drive, and we have a whistle underneath. That's going to be on Becton, 5'8", sophomore. Becton's been running the point so far for Andrews. So
Andrews not really that deep point. And so because of that, that's going to be interesting. 22, Makee Oliveira.
Yes, sir.
Is checking into the game.
So now he'll be running the point for Andrews. This is Jackson underneath, and he threw that one away. Picked off by Simpson. Ball played ahead. This is Vanderpolski. Pulls up, mid-range jumper, knocks it down off the glass, and he's got five. 21-9.
And Great Lakes has to do a better job. It's a 12-point game. And
Parks inside to Bentley. Kick out Howard. Lakes moving the ball a little bit better on this trip. Colton for three, no good. Open look. Offensive rebound for Bentley. The Lakes have only been grabbing one out of every six misses this season. That Jackson knocks it down.
23, Vidal Jackson.
And right there, you move the ball around, you give Vidal an open shot. That's what this team has to do. This team has always had solid shooters, but because of the lack of ball movement, they don't get high percentage shots.
Offensive rebound by Tommy Bentley doesn't hurt either.
No.
12-25 to go
Something
here in the first.
Something that we haven't done this year much of either. And so
Lakes down nine. This is Simpson down low, all the way across. Vanderpolski tries to drive, kick out. Great ball movement from Andrews, but he walked. Oliveira took that extra step.
Turnover.
And right now there, we have a whistle.
Jimmy Harvey's checking in for Vidal Jackson.
So Harvey checks in for Jackson, and now Nathan Shelton is about to check in, replacing Tommy Bentley. So Bentley, Parks, Harvey, Howard, and Colton on the floor for Great Lakes, down nine.
And you know, you've seen so far Great Lakes playing better defense, but you also seen when they move the ball, when they aren't stationary with the ball, good things happen.
Howard tries to drive, and we have a whistle, and that's a touch foul on Vanderpolski.
Foul on 32.
And you know,
it's first.
A lot of people like to complain about what the refs call, but I've learned, and you will back this up, whatever they call is what they call. So Vanderpolski can either learn that they're going to call it a handshake, or he can keep handshaking and picking up tacky fouls.
Well, that's something that Great Lakes have struggled with this year as well, is not recognizing when referees are calling what,
right,
and not making that adjustment. Hopefully tonight they can see that. And the last touch, ooh, I think David Parks might have gotten away with that.
And
last touch, they're going to call it off of Oliveira. I'm pretty sure Parks is the last one to touch it, though.
Once again, as I said earlier, that was a soft pass. I mean, I'm not the fleet of foot, but I could have got my hand on that. You've got to put some up behind the pass, you know what I mean?
Parks pulls for three. No good off the back rim. Coming the other way now, Moon. Gives it to Vanderpolski. Working around the perimeter. Moon pulls for three. No good off the back rim. Rebound tipped out to Colton. Sean Colton brings it up. Feeds it to Howard, who goes up. Gets it blocked. Robert Moon, 6'2 junior, went way up and knocked that away. And Howard, who's only about 5'6 or so, isn't going to get that one over the top very easily. Vidal Jackson checks in, replacing David Parks. 11:27 to go here in the first, 21-12. Andrews in the lead. Colton to inbound from the baseline, gives it to Shelton, who gives it to Harvey. Back to Jackson. Working around the perimeter. Nice ball movement into Harvey for two from the free throw line.
Too much on it.
No good. Clanked it off the back rim. Coming the other way now is Makee Oliveira. Now it's picked off by Colton. He's coming the other way.
And
brings
Sean
it forward. Feeds it to Howard, who lays it up and in.
2 points for Quentin Howard.
And right there is why you like Quinton Howard. Quinton Howard's really fast player.
Well, you've got to be if you're 5'6".
Yeah, and he got down court before anyone else was even close to being back down court. And Sean's able to get the easy assist right there.
Working around the perimeter again. This is Oliveira inside to Simpson all the way across. Vander Poske inside to Simpson again. Off the glass, doesn't get the roll. Rebound tipped up and taken by Vidal Jackson, and that's where it's nice to have some size underneath.
Yeah, Great Lakes wasn't able to do that at all first semester. Vidal just reached over his head and got the rebound.
Howard tried to feed that one into Shelton. Last touch by Robert Moon, who was able to knock it over the end line.
We have Tommy Bentley checking in.
Replacing Quinton Howard.
And number 25. Do they have a 25? Who's 25?
There's no 25. That was number one who just checked in,
okay,
Tim McGuire.
Thank you.
Vidal Jackson, Calton underneath, wants Harvey. And I don't know who that touched last, but Shelton saves it, almost saved it in the corner. Nathan, effort play, he couldn't quite keep it in bounds.
I'm not sure who the turnover there was by. I mean, Jimbo and Vidal both went for the ball and collided. So I'm not sure who you give the turnover to right there. I mean,
Makey Oliveira is the one who checked out. He's wearing 22. He's replaced by Tim McGuire.
Thank you, because I didn't see that.
McGuire. Rutledge working on him. Into the corner for three. No good off the front rim. Rebound Harvey. The miss from Vander Poske. Coming the other way is Rutledge running the floor. Rutledge holds up the play. Looking for an option. Feeds it to Shelton. Back to Rutledge, crosses over, loses the ball. Last touch by Rutledge. Tried to take that step inside. He likes to drive to the basket. Hasn't had much success of it so far, going in among the trees. 21-14, Andrews in the lead with 9:50 to go here in the first.
And once again, like we said, there's not a lot of guys quick enough to stay in front of Sean. It doesn't take you long to realize that. And so they're going to overcommit because they don't want him to be able to drive and get easy looks.
2 points for 24 and the five.
It's a pass from number 15, Kobe Meyer makes the layup.
Foul on 25. Tommy Bentley, his first, team third.
That's the first field goal for Andrews in probably 3 minutes or so. Vidal Jackson checks out, Sam Anderson checks in. Moon knocks down the free throw, and it's a 10-point game. 24-14, 9:36 to go here in the first. Rutledge, Anderson, Bentley, Harvey, Shelton on the floor for Great Lakes. Rutledge to Shelton, thought about pulling that up, takes it inside, backs it out to Harvey. Harvey, kick out to Rutledge, they'll reset, 20 to shoot. Bentley, thought about pulling that up, he almost walked, gives it back to Rutledge, 14 to shoot. Rutledge goes around his man, goes inside, feeds it to Anderson, who goes back around, and he walked.
And that's a good feed right there from Rutledge and Sam. I mean, he's not the tall, but he at least has to try to go up and draw the foul, right?
Well, just an unfortunate step. He wanted to kick that back out. Rutledge was coming open in the wing there. That was an opportunity perhaps for Great Lakes, but a walk. That one's fed all the way inside to Simpson and gives it back out to Moon. No good, but he'll go to the line to shoot, too. I think Andrews wanted the alley-oop there. Kobe Meyer floated that one up near the rim.
Foul on 42 White. His first.
So now with 8:55 to go in the first, Andrews up 10, looking to go up 12 with a couple of free throw attempts forthcoming.
And so Sam Anderson with his first foul.
First free throw from Moon, gets the roll.
Sam Anderson took right back out.
Oh. Second free throw from Moon is in and out.
It's a miss.
Coming the other way now is Rutledge, playing with two fouls, drives, and a whistle. They're going to get a hand check on Tim McGuire. That's his first.
Team six.
Bentley plays it in. This is Rutledge.
Trying to slow the game down and work the ball, and people have to move, and they're cutting and rotating.
Bentley pulls up for three. No good off the front rim. Rebound coming the other way is Robert Moon.
And what? One pass and a shot, one pass and a shot, one pass and a shot. It's just not productive offense.
This is Simpson. Into the wing. Vanderpolski into the corner. Back to Vanderpolski working around the perimeter. This is McGuire. McGuire holds up, gives it to Simpson.
Andrews right there just passed up on two wide open looks.
Vanderpolski all the way across to McGuire for three. Gets
3 points for number one.
And John Piercefield wants another timeout. Nathan Shelton's on the ground. No, excuse me, that's Sean Rutledge, 44, not 24, who's on the ground.
Not sure what happened right there. Looks like he got hit in the nose.
Rutledge in some pain.
Looks like his nose is broken.
So 28-14, 8:08 to go here in the first. Sean being helped to his feet by the trainer Carmichael Gully.
We just gotta get the blood to stop. I mean, obviously, we all know you can't play with blood. It's the Cardinal rule. And so on the floor for Andrews, number one, Tim McGuire, number 15, Kobe Mayer, number 32, Brandon Von Dorpolski, number 44, Andrew Simpson, and number 24, Robert Moon.
For the Lakes.
Checking in the game for Sean Rutledge would be number 24, Nathan Shelton, and checking back into the game would be Sean Colton.
So Colton, Bentley, Shelton, Jackson, Parks. This is Shelton in the high post. Swings it around to Parks.
And once again, you see the ball just stops.
This is Shelton again. Colton swings it around to Jackson. Colton. Parks. Back to Colton inside. Bentley, free throw line, turnaround jumper. No good off the back rim. That was a good shot. You got to hit those. Coming the other way now. 7.5 to go in the first. 28-14.
That's a good shot for Tommy. He's got to take his time and knock that down. But once again, that shot came from moving the ball. It came from being patient. Great Lakes took the shot with 8 seconds on the shot clock there, and it was one of the best shots they got in this half. It just didn't go in.
Down low to Moon. Tries to drive, puts it up, gets the roll.
For 24, Robert Moon.
30-14 now, 7:05 to go here in the first. Colton. Feeds it to Jackson, who loses the ball. Coming the other way is McGuire. McGuire pushing the floor. Gives it to Meyer. Down low. Kick out. Vanderpolski stepped on the line.
That's a turnover.
No official word. It appears that he stepped on the sideline. And now...
We got Q and Dana checking in and number 35 checking in.
So now Parks, Jackson, Howard, Colton, and Thomas... Sean Rutledge is down on the bench. Appears to be fine. He's not checked back in yet, though. Jackson. Parks. Inside. Turnaround jumper for Colton. No good off the back rim. He's not shot particularly well since coming back from the break. Hopefully he can get that back soon. Tim McGuire over the timeline. Lakes down 16. Moon.
Moving the ball and getting open looks. And that wasn't a bad look. We just got to knock him down.
Inside, Cedric Anderson, kick back out to Vanderpolski, and we have a whistle.
A foul on number 10.
It's going to be on Dana Thomas. I believe that's
his
first.
His first team fifth.
So,
Robert Moon checks it in from the baseline. This is Meyer. Down low. That's knocked away, but he's able to pick it back up. Kick out, McGuire. Andrews working the ball around the perimeter now. Moon back to McGuire for three, knocks
three
it down.
For number one.
McGuire's got six, and the Lakes are in a 19-point hole. Howard drives, kick out, Parks. Thomas down the baseline, kick out to Jackson for three. No good off the back rim, rebound coming the other way. Cedric Anderson. Robert Moon, Tim McGuire, Down low, coming inside, Vanderposky. Working around Robert Moon. Inside Meyer. Down low. Anderson gets inside, knocks it down.
Cedric Anderson.
And John Piercefield wants a timeout. Fourteen unanswered for Andrews. And the Lakes are down 21. What can the Lakes do to stem the tide here?
It starts on defense right now. It starts on defense and getting better shots and just playing more aggressive, because right now they aren't playing aggressive. They're playing passive and they have to wake up. And I mean, it's 5 minutes and 21 seconds left in the half, and right now Great Lakes has to be thinking of about not going into halftime in a double-digit hole and cutting it to single digits to have a chance to come back in the second half. But right now, it just doesn't look good for Great Lakes. And as we said before, we said it on Saturday, we said it again on Tuesday, this is not the same team we saw before Great Lakes.
They've been sluggish, to be fair. It's not been the best. It needs to be better. And the shooting hasn't been there today. The offense has not worked the ball around consistently. Defensively, guys are getting open looks. Guys are getting inside way too easily, especially given the size on the roster now. Guys are getting inside just as easily as they ever have.
Right. And so you got Sean checking in for Q.
So good to see Rutledge back in the game. Obviously not a big deal with the nose.
Yeah, I mean, Sean's a competitor. Sean's not going to stay out long.
Rutledge over the timeline to Colton. Takes a step, gives it to Jackson, back to Colton. The Lakes have got to work their offense. Parks holding up. Now he's lost his dribble. Pass underneath to Jackson, who goes up, and he's fouled.
And one of the things about Liddell.
35, block.
One of the things about Liddell is that Liddell's a really, really skilled shooter, but he's played the post his whole life. So it'll be interesting to see if Great Lakes starts taking advantage of the fact that Liddell actually has a pretty solid post game as well. Now, can he make his free throws?
Misses the first off the back rim.
So that makes him 1-for-3 right now today. Because this is third, so they got to make free throws.
Makes the second, but we have a lane violation. So it's going to be on Thomas, lane violation, 5:05 to go in the first. 5:05 to go in the first. Lakes down 35-14. Lane violation called on Thomas. This is Vanderposky. McGuire back to Meyer. Under five now left in the first half. Vanderposky being worked on by Colton. Gives it up. Meyer. Anderson gets through, now he lost the ball, and did he walk? No. That's going to be on Colton.
22, block. His
first. What happened there? It looked like 35 slip.
Team six.
And it's the foul on Sean Colton. It looked like he slipped. I'm not sure we're watching it here live, but let's see.
No, I think they got that one right. They looked up, just saw the replay. Looks like they got that one right. Coming around the other way now. Driving inside is Anderson, goes to the rack, no good. Parks with the board, coming the other way. Gives it to Colton. Lakes running the floor, only 2-on-5. Colton's going to hold it up, give it to Parks. Open look, he's not going to take it. 4.5 left in the first. Still holding up. Now he's still holding it. Inside to Jackson, spins away, goes up. It's knocked out of his hand, and he goes to the floor. He'll go to the line again.
Foul on 35. Push.
So Fidel's going to get two more free throws. He was 1-for-2 his last time.
Teammate.
And so now he's got to make both of these, because, I mean, he's still 1-for-3 because you didn't count the other one. But
if you're going to go to the line as often as Jackson's gone, you got to start making these. 4:24 to go in the first. Knocks down the first.
The first.
We got number 5 and number 44 checking in.
So that will be Tyler Bartram.
Taylor, isn't it?
Taylor, excuse me. Taylor Bartram checking into the game for the first time tonight. Andrew Simpson returns to the game. Second free throw from Jackson. No good off the back rim. Rebound Moon.
When a free throw is long, it means you're putting too much on it. Bedell's not, you know, he's shooting too strong.
Moon gives it to McGuire.
So either he needs to back up or he needs to take something off of it.
This is McGuire again, almost loses it. Colton fighting him for it on the floor and a tie up. Nice job by Colton.
And possession goes to Great Lakes, and right there, great defense right there by Sean. He just wants the ball.
This is Rutledge.
Plays like that gets you back in the game.
Thomas. Lakes have scored only 1 point in the past 7 minutes. Parks. Rutledge. Kicks it out to Parks again. Pulls up for three. In and out. This is Colby Meyer. He's being defended by Jackson in the front court. Gives it up to Bartram. Bartram over the timeline. Gives it to McGuire. Rutledge defending him tightly. 5.5 to go here in the first. Simpson. Drives. Gives it up to Meyer underneath. Meyer backing down on Colton, up off the glass and in. Jackson pulls up, three, yes,
three
finally. The field goal drought's over.
And right there, Sean's just like, all right, we're gonna go to the guy who I think can make a shot. He just rubs off of Vidal and just hands him the ball, and Vidal knocks down the shot.
Lakes went about 7 minutes without a field goal.
Can't do that.
Nope, not if you expect to win games. Moon drives, went right around David Parks, and he knocks it down. Went right around David Parks. Parks not a perimeter defender. That one was fed inside to Rutledge, but it was misplayed, it looks like, and Moon's coming the other way, puts it up, no good. Buddy's fouled.
White 10, block. His second, team seven.
Great Lakes has way too many turnovers right now.
At the line,
half.
Shooting two, number 20.
Well, that ball was just fed in. Rutledge was making a run all the way to the baseline, and Thomas tried to feed it to him and just missed him.
He threw it behind him. This is what happened. Yeah, he threw it behind him, and you throw the ball behind him. I mean, he only can do so much. And so he's got to make a better pass there. Makes a better pass. You get an easy layup. When the state throw the ball behind them, you don't get an easy layup. I mean.
Moon knocks down the free throw, and it's 41-18. Rutledge stutter steps over the timeline, walks all the way in, gets no. Doesn't get it to fall. And now we have an officials conference.
And Vidal taking the leadership role and just trying to see if he was shooting. And I think so Bedell, Sean gets to go to the line, and he shot pretty well from the free throw line last game, right? 4 for 5? He's shooting the 1 and 1. So it's not 2. He has to make it to get the other one, and he makes it. So
Rutledge shot 4 for 5 in the last game from the free throw line.
Yeah, and so, I mean, obviously the more free throws he takes, I mean, hopefully it bodes well, 4 for 5, and so, I mean, the more free throws, the better if you shoot that well.
Second free throw from Rutledge is good as well.
Takes them both.
So you like to see that.
You always like to see that.
Rutledge has 4. This is Meyer being defended by Bentley.
And so.
This is Robert Moon.
Right now you see McGuire made a few threes. So you see Sean kind of face guarding McGuire to hopefully take him out of the game and stop him from getting open shots.
Well, one of those problems for the Lakes the last few games has been perimeter defense, and this first half has been no different. That's a long two, in and out. Rebound, Simpson puts it back.
44, Andrew Simpson.
And right there, I mean, Bedell has to pick up number 5. And so Sean gets on the supposed 5'11", Andrew Simpson.
Colton inside, knocks it down.
Sean Colton.
I don't know how that went in. Oh. But it went in.
Is that Colton's first bucket of the game?
Yes.
Wow. You got to get him involved in the offense earlier if you want to have
a
chance.
He's gotten a few good shots. He just hasn't made them.
1:24 to go in the first. And that's an easy run for Simpson.
2 points, number 44.
He had Yeah, Pennsylvania Avenue down in the middle of the floor, and now that one's going to be picked off. Bad pass from Rutledge. Going the other way now. McGuire leaves it. Moon picks it up. No good. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by Colby Meyer.
And
Rutledge brings it up. Tries taking himself, kick out to Bentley, and we have a whistle.
And Sean right there, he saw Tommy and actually would have gotten Tommy a pretty good look.
I think that's going to be on McGuire.
Team 10, two shots.
No, that was a good drive,
yeah.
And it almost worked. Rutledge knocks down the first, and now Maki Oliveira will check in, replacing McGuire. Second free throw from Rutledge is good.
He makes them both.
And Sean makes both his free throws so far, 4-for-4, and as we said, it's 4-for-5 last game, so.
That's helpful, but you're going to have to learn how to shoot from the floor if you're Great Lakes in the second half if you want to have any chance at all in this one.
Right.
And Robert Moon holding it up. 45 seconds coming up. Oliveira picks up his dribble. Now he's in trouble. Gives it up. This is Moon. Back to Oliveira. Feeds it to Meyer. Meyer inside. Good run. And that's blocked by Vidal Jackson. Tipped up in the air and out. Last touch off of Great Lakes.
It's a good defensive play there by Vidal. Being very aggressive. And he's able to get the block.
31 seconds on the game clock. 8 on the shot clock. Inbound. Simpson. Oliveira. Gives it up in the corner, 3. No good off the front rim, long rebound out to Simpson off the miss by Bartram. Works it out to Oliveira. Andrews will work for the last shot. 15 seconds now.
Yep.
This is Moon being defended by Anderson. And we have a hand check on Anderson.
White foul, 42.
And, you know, that's the refs have made that call this whole half.
Yeah, they have. They have. They've been very consistent with that call, and that's something you've got to be aware of.
And so you just have to pay attention to the fact that they're going to call the hand check.
Robert Moon on the free throw line.
And so now he gets a free chance to score, and he knocks down the free throw.
Lakes are going to go into halftime.
Down at least 20. I mean, you make a 3, you sit down 20, you're down 20.
Well, what adjustments do you think that need to be made the most for Great Lakes?
I mean.
Rebound Bentley, coming the other way, 7 seconds. We'll hold that thought. Bentley over the timeline, gives it up to Colton. 3, Vidal with 2, knocks it down, and we'll go to halftime.
3 points for Vidal Jackson.
So the Lakes end the half on a positive note, but there's still a whole lot of work to do. Hey, you said they'd go to the half down 20. They're down 19. Whatever.
That's the free throw. But here's the thing. Let's look at this. 27 points for Great Lakes this half. Vidal Jackson has 14 of those.
That's not a good thing. That's not a good thing. You got to be able to spread the ball around, and they've not done a good job of that right now.
We came into this game talking about how he was the scorer, but you don't want to have him to have to carry that much of a load.
Yep.
Right now, he's carrying the whole load.
Well, half of it anyway.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're going to go to break. We'll be right back with some numbers and some analysis and some thoughts in the second half. 46-27, Andrews lead Great Lakes at the break. Don't go away. This is the Great Lakes Christian College Television Network.
Hello. Hello. like to thank everybody for coming out today. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Appreciate it. Right now, we have a coach on the staff. A lot of things. We're blessed to have him. He loved his school to the core of his heart. That means each individual player, student, and staff would do anything but take his shirt off his back, his last food off his plate. He's definitely a God-fearing man. He's definitely blessed. I thank God that he's in my life. You know, he helped me out a lot. He's a mentor. Call him anytime of night. That's any of them. He takes us to the doctor. He prayed for us. He have us over his house for dinner. And we just wanted to get Carmichael a basketball. We wanted to sign it, let him know that we really, really appreciate him. And I know all the students do too. Does everybody know Carmichael on campus? I think everybody know him at the mall. He's internationally known. And we just want to know, to let you know that we love you. Students, we love them. We love them. The red corner, weighing 125. No, he.
You know, coming here as a non-traditional student is very difficult. Life is a challenge. All God wanted us to do was to love each other as thyself and share that with somebody else. This court right here is our altar. This game is our ministry. The hardest thing to do, and it's getting easier with the help of the administration here, is to get these young men to understand that all God wants is to know your heart. So I share that with you tonight. Anything you do and you're successful at, and if you do it with passion, it comes from your heart. So I challenge you every day, do something for somebody, and if you do, do it out of your heart. Now, you got it. Right. I love you. Everything for you. But I'm challenging you right now. You've got to invest in yourself. We're older, but we're still investing. You've got to make a decision. 2 Chronicles chapter 29, 1 through 9, verse 5. Ask you, are you willing to sanctify your service? In other words, are you willing to set yourself aside and do what you got to do? It's all about this game. It's not about the 3 points. It's about rebounding. You can't run without the ball. It's about thank you.
graduate with a degree. Carmichael is graduating in May. Carmichael is graduating in May. He's getting that bachelor's degree. So at the end of the day, we all gonna get that bachelor's degree, right? That's what I'm talking about.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Doty Center. The second half, Great Lakes Christian College taking on Andrews University, about to tip here. So, the Lakes come out of the locker room down 46-27. What can Great Lakes do to try to fix what's been going on here?
Great Lakes has to do a better job of taking care of the ball. And, it starts on defense, but more importantly, it starts on getting more people involved on offense. As I said, as we talked at half, and that's just too easy. As I said at half, we have 27 points. Vidal has 14 of those. And so
that feed inside to Jackson loses the ball, and it's loose on the ground. We have a tie-up. Robert Moon scored the basket for Andrews. He leads all scorers with 17.
Robert Moon played a very efficient first half.
Outside of Vidal Jackson, the Lakes shot 4 of 15 in the first half.
And there's not much you can do when you shoot like that. I mean, Sean was able to get free throws.
Then do 1 out of 7 from beyond the arc as well.
Right. And so
this is Jackson. Dana Thomas. Inside. Turnaround jumper for Caldwell. Gets swatted out of his hands by Vander Poske. Coming the other way now is Becton, who gives it to Simpson, and he's fouled on the way up by Calton.
And so
I think it's going to be the second on Sean Calton.
Man, Von Borski just was like, I mean, he went up for a shot, and he just stood there and just swatted it away just effortlessly.
Calton and the official are having a conversation.
And Calton just talking politely, doesn't seem to be frustrated or anything, and the referee he was talking to, you see Sean walking away with a smile on his face, just asking the question, which is okay. Just trying to figure out what's going on. And
Simpson's second free throw is good. Jackson to Thomas. 19-10 to go here in second. Lakes down 23. Rutledge, kick out, Anderson. Back to Thomas. He holds it up, 12 to shoot. Calton, down low to Anderson, kick out to Calton, tries to drive, gives it up to Rutledge, 6 to shoot. Rutledge gonna reset, 4 to shoot. 3, tries to drive, puts it up, doesn't get it off the back, gets his own board, loses the ball. Gabriel Becton will get the steal there. Coming the other way, Simpson goes above the rim and he's fouled by Jackson, who just didn't want to slam it down. So now Simpson will have to earn his points from the line. Not a bad foul from Jackson, really. I believe that's only his second. First free throw from Simpson is good. So Andrews basically picking up right where they left off, scoring the first 5 points in the second half.
And really, Great Lakes really struggling with the same things that they've been struggling with all game. Lack of movement, lack of work in the ball around, you know. You work it around, you get the ball in 5 seconds, and it's stuck, and Sean has to try to make a play. He gets a pretty decent shot, but it's still not good enough. It's still not efficient offense.
Andrews back to Calton for 3. No good off the front rim, and we have a whistle underneath. And it's going to be on Anderson. I think it's third.
It's third.
And so Tommy Bentley will check in the game for Sam Anderson. And Great Lakes has to be looking from a spark from somebody. I mean, at this point, you know, Andrews looked at the stat sheet at halftime, so they know the only person to score for Great Lakes is Vidal. And so as you see, they're doing a better job on Vidal. They're swarming when he gets the ball. And really, they're going to say someone else has to beat us.
That's Becton. He's got 4. Rutledge rings it up. Drives, loses the ball. Rutledge trying too hard to get it inside. That's a long ball ahead. This is picked up by Moon, goes to the rack. Doesn't get the roll, and we have a tie-up. Jimbo Harvey will check in, as will David Parks, and they're going to replace Dana Thomas with Sean Rutledge. John Piercefield opting to go with a taller lineup now. I believe he's got his five tallest guys on the floor right now. This is Vanderpolsky, drives, kick out. Becton, back to Vanderpolsky. Becton, working on Colton. Gives it to Simpson. Meyer tries to drive and he scores.
And once again, he just goes right by Sean Colton.
10-0 run for Andrews to start the half. Parks works around the perimeter, gives it to Jackson. Colton in the corner, gives it down low to Bentley, who's trapped, gives it to Harvey, goes up, and there's a whistle. And he's just going to go to the free throw line, it looks like.
Yeah.
That's going to be on Simpson. So they will consider it a shooting foul.
44.
Harvey, first free throw. No good off the front rim. That wasn't very good.
I'm not sure what that one was.
Second free throw from Harvey. Doesn't get the roll. Vanderpolsky.
Second one was better than the first one.
Yeah, but gosh. Vanderpolsky brings it up. Under 17 to go here in the second. Andrews currently on a 10-0 run. Meyer, Simpson, Harvey working on him in defense. This is Moon down underneath to Meyer. No good, and it goes out over the end line.
And right there, I mean, no one's botching out. And so, virtually, they don't get a rebound, so they don't get a new shot clock, but they keep the ball.
Meyer gives it up, down low. Vanderpolsky goes up and under, knocks it down.
And he just goes right by David Parks. And it's a 12-0 run.
Colton into the corner. This is Parks. Works it around all the way across to Bentley. Gives it to Jackson in the corner. All the way across to Parks. Gives it back to Jackson, who tries to drive. Goes up. No good. Rebound Harvey. The putback is good and one.
For Timmy Harvey and the foul.
And that's what Jimbo does. Jimbo's the garbage man. And Jimbo trailed the play right there. Like he does, and he got the rebound. And Danny Brugger will now check into the game for David Parks. And
first action of the game for Brugger.
Cedric Anderson, I believe, right?
Yes.
Checks into the game for Andrew Simpson. And now Jimbo will get a chance to complete the three-point play. And hopefully the free throw doesn't look as bad as the first one. And, yeah.
He's going to have to work on that. Coming the other way now is Gabriel Becton. Andrew's doubling up the Lakes right now, and Brandon Vanderpolsky appears to be favoring some fingers on that right hand. This is Becton, pulls up, mid-range two, no good. Rebound, Colton, and we have a whistle on Vanderpolsky.
Foul on 32.
Vanderpolsky seems to be all right. Colton will inbound from the baseline.
And right there, Vanderpolsky just start. I mean, Sean's a good rebounder. Sean holds on to the ball tight. He just thought he was going to be able to come in time up, and Sean wasn't going to let that happen.
Bentley gets it knocked out of his hands underneath. This is Moon. Gives it to Vanderpolsky. Long ball ahead, and Bleegar got in the way of Becton. No whistle. Coming the other way now is Colton after the steal by Harvey to Bentley underneath. No good. Harvey gets the board, and he's fouled.
Second.
And Jimbo just doing what he can right now, you know. You have to admire him. I mean, Jimbo obviously doesn't have the lift and the same ability that we're used to seeing from Jimmy Harvey, but we know one thing about Jimmy Harvey, and he on net on the free throw. But we know one thing about Jimmy Harvey, and in every sport he plays, he's gonna give 110%. He's gonna work as hard as he can, and he's one of those players He's one of those players that you like because he's a grinder. The second free throw's no good, and Cedric Anderson gets the rebound. Now they're bringing the ball up court.
And we have a whistle. They're going to get Calton again. I believe that's his third.
And Sean, unfortunate right there, was trying to anticipate the pass. And so he jumped in the air, and he wasn't passing the ball. So
inbound from Shelton. Excuse me, from Moon. This is Vondroposky. Meyer. Vondroposky up top. Gives it to Anderson. Back to Vondroposky. Drives after the pump. Goes in. No good. Rebound picked up by Jackson coming the other way. Jackson, kick out to Calton. Down low. Harvey spins, puts it up. No good off the back rim. Rebound coming the other way. Colby Meyer gives it to
Becton.
That's
a great move by Jimbo. He just wasn't able to make it. But those are things that you want to see for Jimmy coming back from an injury, because everything right now is about what they can do at regionals. And if Jimbo can get his strength back and get back to being the Jimbo that we're used to seeing, he's a huge component on this team.
Robert Moon knocks down the deuce.
Robert Moon has 19. And it's a 30-point game.
14 minutes now left in the second. Vidal pulls up three, no good off the back rim. Long rebound out to Becton. No one contested him for it. Becton goes all the way in, kicks underneath Vondroposky, gives it to Bentley instead. And now Jimmy Harvey lays it in off the glass on the transition.
And
Jimbo trying to bring some intensity to the floor. Becton brings it over the timeline. Lakes down 28.
We all know that Jimbo's intent and purpose of being on the floor is energy.
Anderson loses it to Meyer, and Danny Bleegar tried to dive to the floor to grab it. Probably didn't need to do that.
He goes over
the sideline, and it's turnover.
Danny actually needed to dive for that. I think that was going to go out of bounds to be Great Lakes ball, but you appreciate the hustle and effort.
Becton.
So
gives it to Anderson. Meyer goes right around Danny Bleegar and lays it. No, he doesn't get it, but he gets the board. And now he's surrounded by defenders, but he goes up and puts it in anyway. Meyer's got 10.
And someone's got to box him out. He misses the shot, and everyone, I think, probably anticipated that it would go in.
Calton fed that one underneath to Bleegar, who couldn't handle it. It rolls to Harvey, who puts it in.
I'm going to give an assist to Bleegar right there.
No.
Bleegar, he plays so.
No, the Lakes got a bit lucky on that trip to get the basket, but they're still down 28.
And as my partner said, the Lakes got a bit lucky right there. Sean Cone throws the ball to Danny Bleegar, who's unable to handle it. Jimmy Harvey sees the ball on the ground, picks it up, and gets the easy, uncontested layup. And so it's 2 points for Great Lakes. And Jimmy Harvey just trying to instill energy into this team. It's something that they've been lacking for a few games. And if Jimbo can come back and just instill that into this team, it's important.
Well, Harvey's a good motivator. He's played pretty well so far. He's been in on all of the action, at least, down low. This is Anderson down low, and I think he just threw that away.
And right there, Jimmy Harvey sees the guys cutting through, and like you're talking to them, you bump them. He bumps them, the ball goes straight out of bounds.
Calton
brings
it up.
Nothing illegal about the play.
Over the timeline, tries to get a screen from Harvey, gives it to Bleegar. Bleegar thought about it, gives it to Calton instead. Now to Jackson, back to Calton, working around the perimeter. Bentley thought about it, gives it inside to Harvey. Tries to spin away, and we have a whistle. Oh, man, I don't agree with that one. Gabriel Becton is going to get whistled for that. Looked like he got all ball.
You can understand right there why the ref would make the call. Jimmy grabs the ball, he puts it in tight. And Becton is trying to force Jimmy to loosen his grip on the ball, and so he got the foul because of that.
Calton inside. Harvey goes up strong and missed it completely. Coming the other way is Colby Meyer. Gives it to Becton. He'll bring it up over the timeline. Meyer goes around Harvey, gives it to Becton in the corner. Under 12 left, and that one's going to be kicked away by Buigar. He is a soccer player.
By trade. So right there, he kicks the ball.
We've seen some good effort from some of these guys who've come off the bench, Harvey and Buigar especially, but it's not translated into many points for the Lakes, and they find themselves in a very large hole. For three, Von der Poski, no good off the front rim. Rebound, Anderson. Lakes unable to board underneath right now. Moon. Back to Becton.
And so, one of the other things that Jimbo does is he talks.
And we have an offensive foul
on Cedric Anderson.
They're going to get Cedric Anderson.
Checking into the game, David Parks for Jimmy Harvey.
Buigar, Parks, Bentley, Jackson, and this is Sean Colton on the ball. Colton underneath. He wanted Jackson, but it's stolen away. Coming the other way is Van der Poski, and they're going to get Colton for the block, and that's four. So at 11:24 to go, Sean Colton's picked up his fourth. Moon to inbound, gives it to Becton.
You don't want Sean to pick up his fifth, so you expect to see a substitution fairly soon.
Moon, Becton in the corner, picks up a screen. Good defense there, down underneath. Anderson, no shot. They're going to get Buigar for the foul, his first. Good switch by Colton and Buigar there. Colton picks up Becton, and Buigar goes inside. What happens when you switch there is Buigar's now got to deal with the much larger Cedric Anderson.
So Danny working as hard as he can. He's undersized. He's not a soccer player by trade, but he's doing everything he can.
Inbound. Meyer. Inside. Robert Moon goes up, knocks it down.
2 points for number 24.
I believe that's 21 for Robert Moon.
Yeah, and Sean, what can Sean do today? Doesn't fifth.
Parks. Under some pressure. Trying to get away from Van der Poski, gives it to Buigar. Buigar works it around, gives it to Colton. Colton tries to drive, and we have a foul on Moon. I think that's his third.
Foul on 24, Black. His third. Team 7, 1-1.
He's now going to the line to shoot the 1-1 will be Sean Colton.
Jimmy's checking in for Tommy Bentley.
Colton about a 63% free throw shooter.
Really, Colton just
knocks it down.
It's mate.
And once again, as I said, how long do you leave Sean Colton out there with four fouls?
He's not been in Colton's best game. He's only got 3 points.
Yeah, and four fouls, 3 points.
Second free throw is in and out. Rebound coming the other way, Anderson. To Moon, to Becton, who runs the floor. 10:45 to go in the second. Lakes down 29. Anderson inside. Meyer working on Parks. It's knocked away by Harvey. Buigar picks it up. Harvey going to take it inside on Becton. Off the glass, knocks it down.
Number 21, Jimmy Harvey.
Good steal by Harvey. He hits it to Buigar, who feeds it ahead, and Harvey finishes. Good defensive play turns into a basket.
I was really nervous as to what Jimbo was going to do. And Jimbo being strong enough, Becton hits the ball, and Jimbo fights through it.
Meyer to Anderson, and we have a whistle before the shot. That's going to be on Buigar, his second.
And once again,
as we've said time and time again, you have to notice that these refs are calling the hand check.
Yep.
And so you're reaching in like they haven't caught this all game.
Anderson's first free throw is good.
They've caught the hand check the whole game.
And that's an awareness thing. That's really what that is. Second one for Anderson is good. And we have a substitution. Hey, Ben Ashton will check into the game for the first time tonight.
Obviously, probably a guy doesn't play a lot, but with 10 minutes to go and a 29-point lead, Andrews is like, well, we can afford to put him in, apparently.
Colton will bring it up the floor, playing with four fouls. Parks pulls up for three, no good, rolls around and drops out. Jackson gets the offensive board, goes to the rack, and he's fouled. That's going to be on Meyer.
15 black. His first teammate.
Not sure who that foul was on. Was it 13 black?
They're going to get Colby Meyer, number 15.
15 black. Okay, thank you. So Vidal Jackson steps in line to get two more free throws.
Gets the first.
He makes it.
Vidal is having a pretty decent first game. Not a great first game, but a pretty decent one.
He's been pretty quiet in the second half.
Doing a better job of guarding him. I mean, a guy scores 14 of a team's 27 points. You obviously are going to know where he's at in the second half because of that.
He makes both of those. He's 4-for-7 now for the game, and now he's down. That looks like a cramp.
And that's just, I mean, unfortunately, it just cramps up. And
yep, that's not a, doesn't appear to be anything serious, just a cramp. It hurts like crazy, but.
You know, just got to stay hydrated and things to not cramp up. And, I mean, if you've never played sports, you don't understand how a cramp feels. But if you have played sport, when you or you have a trolley horse, it hurts.
9:56 to go here in the second. Lakes trailing this one 66. Lakes down 66-39. So. Jackson's still down. Getting that leg stretched out. So, less than 10 minutes now. Second half, what can Great Lakes get from this game in this situation where it's unlikely that you're going to launch any kind of comeback?
At this point, they just got to get certain people in rhythm. Sean Relich is not playing in the second half, not able to get in the rhythm. Sean Cote needs to get back in the rhythm that we saw him in before the semester was over. And so right now, it's about people getting in rhythm and about establishing the things that they can do well. Because there are things that these guys can do that they aren't doing, and they need to be established.
Jackson and walks off under his own power. That's good.
And every game right now is a game for the next game. You just have to get better.
Ben Ashton brings it up the floor. Gives it to Vonderpolski. Becton. 9:45 left in the second. 22 to shoot. Gives it to Moon. Top of the key. Holding up, being defended by Harvey. Gives it to Meyer now. Being defended by Anderson at the perimeter. This is Ashton again, being defended by Colton. Lakes doing a good job protecting the perimeter on this trip. Vonderpolski, 5 to shoot. 3-2. He's just going to jack up an NBA 3.
And
no
flop.
Good. Nice job there on the perimeter defense for Great Lakes. Rebound to Harvey, and that one's going all the way into Anderson. And the Lakes get the turnaround and the basket. So a nice. So first of all, a nice stop on defense. And you come down the other way, you get the bucket. That's the kind of stuff Great Lakes needs to see. Those are building blocks.
Yeah, I have to point out that 32 tried the Manu Ginobili flop. It was a pretty bad flop.
Inside now, this is Meyer.
But Great Lakes is able to capitalize on that. That's what happens when you hit the ground for no reason. And
Becton puts it up, no good. Rebound Harvey. But yeah, good transition basket for the Lakes. One of the few highlights tonight. Colton, kick out. Parks looking for three. And he didn't find it. Coming the other way now, Becton with the board. Gives it up to Meyer, and he lays it in nicely. Colton brings it up. Harvey underneath the basket, he couldn't corral it, and then he gets tripped up. He appears to be okay.
Yeah, just took an unfortunate tumble there. Pass had a little bit too much more on it than he expected, and so because of that he wasn't able to corral it, and as we know, Jimbo's gonna sell out for the ball, sells out for it, takes an unfortunate tumble.
So
inside, Moon knocks it down.
23 points for Robert Moon. And
Colton throws it all the way back to Buigar. Parks back across to Colton, pulls for three. No good off the front rim. Lake's not shooting well. Coming the other way now, McGuire, who just checked in.
And as you say quite often about Sean
and oh, Colton. He may have gone over and back there. No whistle. Meyer.
And as you say about Sean Colton quite a bit, he's not that good of a three-point shooter. And today, he's not shot well at all.
For three, and that's blocked by Harvey. McGuire picks up the board. Back to three, yes.
Number one, Tim McGuire.
And that's good block by Harvey, but sometimes what happens on the block and the ball bounces free, it bounces somewhat. You just can't anticipate where that ball's going.
Yeah, that's the unfortunate thing about a block.
Parks gives it to Buigar. Coming up on seven to play. This is Parks again. Inside to Harvey. Turnaround. Back out to Parks. Pulls up for three. Gets it to fall.
There it is.
3 points for number 30, David Parks.
That's only David's second made shot today. He's taken probably about 9 or 10. How many shots did David Parks take in the first half?
And that was knocked away by Harvey off the foot of Meyer.
And I don't know where the foul was there on Jimmy Harvey.
Looked like Harvey got the ball on that one. 73-44. Rutledge will check in, as will Howard, replacing Buigar and Colton.
So we got a 1-1 for Mayer. Meyer. So you guys gonna take the first free throw. It's good. So it's a 30-point game with 649 to go. Score 74-44. Sorry.
Now
75.
It's 75 as Meyer makes both. Howard. Harvey. Inside. Anderson. And did he walk? No. We have a whistle. I think they're going to get Becton. No. Meyer.
Meyer, 15. And Becton,
his second.
I have to let it be known, Becton right now, 16 points, 6 rebounds, 8 assists.
Becton?
No, Mayer.
Okay,
Meyer.
For Meyer. I was going to say, those are the quietest 16 points I've ever seen in my life. Anderson knocks down the first. I feel like we say this on almost every broadcast, but you got to like the potential of Sam Anderson.
Yes.
He's a good athlete. He hustles around the ball.
Works hard.
Works very hard. Knocks down the second, and he's put a lot of work into the free throws, too, which is good to see, and you can see it right there. It's all paid off. Shoots about 75% from the line on the year. McGuire gives it to Becton.
And Great Lakes needs to get someone else on number one, and David Parks is not the guy you want on number one. Sean and David need to switch right now.
Becton almost gets that knocked out of his hand by Harvey. Gives it to Moon. Back to Becton. Howard wants the steal. Becton gets away. Kick out. Moon causes Rutledge to jump. Drives all the way in. No good. Good defense by Harvey. The rebound by Meyer. And he gets it. And one on Parks. Lakes got a little over-aggressive defensively, and it cost him. A trip to the line.
Meyer will be shooting to complete three-point plan, he does.
What are the numbers for Andrews from the line tonight?
You know, I'll have to look. I'll be able to tell you at the next time out.
Parks pulls up for three. No good off the front rim. Rebound. Heads out to Ashton. Long ball ahead to Moon. Moon tries to feed underneath. It's stolen by Harvey. Harvey able to keep possession and gives it to Rutledge, who brings it over the timeline. Rutledge has had a fairly quiet night. Gives it to Howard. Tries to drive, kick out, good kick. Parks pulls up for three over Becton and knocks it down. That's a matchup for David Parks. He's got 10 inches on Gabriel, or he's at, 8 inches
ten
on
inches
Gabriel Becton.
Quite a bit, partner. But I understand he has 8 inches, and that's a good play by Q, however.
That was.
He drives in, sees David, gets David a pretty open look.
Meyer, kick out, three. McGuire, no good off the back rim. Rebound, Harvey. Rutledge brings it up, almost lost it, keeps it. Kick out, Howard, Harvey, takes a step, puts it up, no good, gets his own rebound, and saves it to Rutledge, who drives, feeds underneath to Harvey, who knocks it down. And timeout, Andrews. A couple of good trips for Great Lakes right there on both ends of the floor, and the lead's cut to 27.
And Jimmy Harvey out there doing everything he can, playing as hard as he can, and you just have to hope that the team picks up on this energy before the season's over. You know, you have guys who are leaders that lead by talking and being boisterous and doing things, and you have guys like Jimbo, who's going to go out there, he's going to give you everything you got, he's going to lead by example, and this team has to admire everything that Jimbo is giving them right now, because Jimbo is just about 5 or 6 months removed from a torn MCL.
Yep.
And it may not even be that long. And so, as you said, what can Great Lakes take from this game? The biggest thing Great Lakes has to take for this game is that they have to be intense.
Yep.
They have to play harder. They have to work harder. And you think the next game, I believe, is against Rochester. And if you aren't going to be intense and work hard against Rochester, it's going to be a long night.
Lakes will be at Rochester next Wednesday. And then we'll get another week off before hosting Grace Bible College here. That is the big one. That's the one that looms large right now. Tim McGuire being defended by Rutledge, who's getting all up in his face. And they're going to get Rutledge for the hand check. a little bit too much intensity, I guess, for Rutledge. I don't know. He got all up in his face, and he was yelling at him, and referee didn't like it much. So now, McGuire will go to the line to shoot one and one.
That's a difficult situation. Sean's playing good defense. He's pushing Sean back.
McGuire will go to the line.
And you can't.
First one's good.
You can't clear him out with his arm, you know. Mike Vickers plays defense like that, and Mike used to get caught for pushing off all the time last year. You can't do that.
McGuire's second free throw is no good off the back rim. Gets his own rebound. It's a long one. Gives it to Oliveira, being defended by Rutledge. Gets away from Rutledge, goes all the way in, but he can't get it. Well defended by David Parks to get a hand up there. Bill Jackson picks up the board. Gives it to Rutledge, running the point. Rutledge gives it to Howard. Wraps around, goes inside underneath to Jackson. Good feed and a good finish as well. Judging from the crowd noise, you wouldn't think that the Lakes are down 26.
Who passed that? Hugo Rutledge.
That was Howard, I believe, who fed that one in. It was a nice feed.
And Q and Sean seem to play well together. They're both really fast. They move the ball around, and Q and Sean seem to play well together.
We have a whistle.
And Great Lakes has to look for the other thing they have to look for is lineups that work, that make them effective. Lineups that are going to work, that make teams play hard and things like that.
Ashton will inbound from the baseline. Now this is McGuire being defended by Rutledge. Rutledge is a very tight defender. He likes to get in the face of the ball handler.
And as you see this time, McGuire doesn't push off, as he knows Rutledge just talked to the refs about
Oliveira for three. No good off the front rim, and that rebound's going to go out over the baseline. Good job by Jackson to not try to do too much with that.
I got it.
Rutledge, nice, pulls up for two. Meyer over the timeline, gonna take it himself, and Park's got a hand in there. They're gonna get him for a whistle. Or they're gonna get him for a foul there with the whistle.
And David just, his lateral movement just has to be better.
His first.
I mean, he just goes straight by David. And David's got to have better lateral movement there. This it's just him one-on-one. He can't just blow by you.
This is Meyer on the free throw line. Hits the side of the rim, rolls around, and drops out.
5-24 checking in for McGuire and Ashton.
So Bartram and Moon will check back in. Meyer on the free throw line.
Oliveira and Simpson, the other two on the floor for the Cardinals. Jackson to Rutledge. Rutledge over the timeline. Going to try to go in, and he's going to get bumped off the ball by Oliveira. Now Nathan Shelton will check in with the scorer's table and re-enter the game.
Black 22.
It's on Oliveira.
And once again, they call a hand check. I wish we could know how many hand checks they've called tonight, because they've called it all night.
Well, they've been consistent about it. So when they're being consistent about it, it's something you need to watch for. We've mentioned that a few times tonight. Rutledge will go to the free throw line and shoot two.
Yep.
Knocks down the first.
And Rutledge hasn't had a great game, not been a terrible game either.
He's been quiet. The Lakes are probably going to ask for a little more out of him in terms of scoring production. He shot well from the free throw line. He's 5-for-6 on the night, but
yeah,
or 4-for-5 rather. But this is Meyer. Simpson back to Meyer. Tries to drive on Anderson. Anderson gets a hand up. Meyer able to get the roll. Not bad defense, just Meyer has a few inches on Sam Anderson.
He just throws the ball up.
Rutledge, three to go. Gives it to Vidal Jackson into the corner to Parks. Swings it all the way across to Rutledge, who puts it on the floor. Kick out, Shelton. Back to Parks. Lakes and trying to move the ball, trying to come up with something here on this trip. Parks to Shelton in the high post. Puts up three and airballed it. I'm not sure what's going on with Shelton the last couple of games. He's not shot well from outside. Long ball ahead to Simpson, who goes up, misses the layup. The putback from Moon is in. And we have a whistle and a timeout called by John Pierce.
Substitution timeout, Great Lakes.
Okay, substitution timeout. So yeah, Nathan Shelton is 2-for-11 from three this semester. I'm not sure what's going on with that. Came into this semester leading the team in three-point shooting percentage. Rutledge, Shelton. Inside, back out to Shelton. Thought about pulling that up. Feeds it underneath to Bentley, who couldn't handle it, but he's able to pick it up and gives it in back to Shelton, who goes to the rack. Oh, no good off the front rim. Coming the other way now. 84-56, Andrews in the lead. Long ball ahead to Simpson, and he goes to the hole and puts it in. Coming the other way now, Rutledge. 2 minutes to go. Lakes down 30. Rutledge tries to drive. We have a whistle. Quinton Howard and Sam Anderson will both check back in. That's going to be on Oliveira.
Great Lakes down 30, and people start being aggressive a little bit too late, and it just doesn't help.
All right, Rev, what did we learn today?
You learned quite a bit about this team.
First free throw's good from Rutledge.
You learned quite a bit about this team. One of the things you've learned about this team is that Jimbo's energy is going to be huge for the rest of the semester. The other thing you learned about this team, we talked about why Munson last game is not playing this game, which is unfortunate.
And Meyer will check it in from the baseline. Long ball in, and Sam Anderson defending. He's able to get the steal. Gives it to Bentley. That's a football instinct right there. He turned around and was able to locate the ball. Bentley gives it to Howard. Down low, and that he passed it right to Simpson. Simpson throws it ahead to Oliveira. Howard trying to get it back, but Moon will lay it in right over the top. Third-point game once again, 1:25 to go. Howard, Thomas, all the way across, wanted Shelton, and he missed him. Meyer.
Way too much on that pass there.
Into Bartram. Back to Oliveira. Taylor Bartram. Back to Oliveira. Still outside the perimeter. Goes in. Moon. Goes for the layup. No good, but he's fouled on the way up by Anderson. 61 seconds left in this one.
Yeah.
Sam Anderson will check out of the game to something of an ovation from the crowd. I think everyone appreciates his effort. It doesn't always show on the stat line, but he gives more effort than just about anybody else.
Yeah, I mean, in this whole rest of the semester, you should be able to see Sam and Jimbo play together, which should be good. And you see Sean goes in, and he's talking to Tommy. And Sean and Tommy were switched, and they finally switched around.
Robert Moon knocks down the free throw. Danny Buigar checks into the game.
And Danny's checking in for Tommy.
So Bentley will exit.
And so Moon has 28 right now. Gets another free throw.
Make it 29. He's had a great game tonight. Rutledge with the ball now, 1 minute to go. Lakes down 90-58, gives it to Howard. That one knocked off of Oliveira. Shelton picks it back up. Back to Howard. Thomas fumbles it a little bit, picks it back up. 22 to shoot. Howard tries to drive, puts up a mid-range jumper, no good. Rebound Meyer coming the other way now, gives it to Oliveira. Oliveira, it's knocked up in the air, and we have a whistle. Think they're going to get... No. Went out of bounds. Okay, so Quinton Howard
out of bounds is the call. Great Lakes
apparently
basketball.
Forced a turnover one way or the other.
A turnover away team, I suppose. I'm not sure what happened there, but it was a turnover, and so...
Howard to Thomas. Shelton. 30 seconds. This is Thomas. Still working around the perimeter. Gives it to Buigar. Gives it back to Howard. Howard tries to get inside. Kick back out to Thomas. Long two. No good. That was a good feed. Offensive rebound out to Buigar, who feeds it to Thomas. Puts up a two. No good off the front rim. Rebound loose underneath the basket. It's going to be picked up. This is Oliveira now. 5 seconds, throws it, and it's over the timeline, and that's going to do it. Simpson will run this clock out, and Andrews will win this one, 90-58. So not the best of efforts from Great Lakes tonight. So we saw some good stuff. Jimbo Harvey brought some energy. Sam Anderson played pretty well. We saw some good shooting from Vidal Jackson. Sean Rutledge got involved. But there's still a lot of work to do if we want this team to compete at regionals in February, beyond the first day.
And a lot of that work starts with
coming out tonight and cheering for Great Lakes basketball.
It starts with being united. It starts with working harder, being more intense, and being more of a team. Things that aren't going on right now. And so,
on a positive note, Sean Rutledge appears to be fine after. What looked like to be a bloody nose. And then Vidal Jackson recovered nicely from a cramp, so those guys are both healthy, which is good, but the performance tonight was lacking. The Lakes are going to need to do better if they want to win at regionals in a month and a half. So, any final thoughts?
Final thoughts here. David Thomas walks off the court and just not the best of games. Sean Colton, captain of the team, sees him, knows they play after the game, runs after him, brings him back out. Not an easy thing to do after you take a loss like that. And so there are things that are in the right place, but being more intense on the court, being more united, working the ball around will go a long way for this team to get better. That's what has to happen. And so Great Lakes has to do a better job of figuring things out. And once they do that, they will be a better team.
All right. Well, that's just about going to do it for us. Final score here, Andrews University 90, Great Lakes Christian College 58. Check us out on Twitter at GLCC Sports. Check us out on our website, glcc.edu/athletics, for a full game report about today's game with stats and numbers and all kinds of fun stuff. So be sure to check that out. Next game. On the road at Rochester in 6 days, Wednesday the 21st of January. The Lakes on the road at Rochester. Listen to us live on meridix.com, meridix.com. Search Great Lakes. That will be January the 21st at 7 o'clock. Lakes